you think the Western world has an accurate or fair viewpoint for Dharmic religions now?
In fact, look up the media presentation. You'll be very surprised, and I watch it as well. If you look at the big BBC big questions or the moral issues being discussed, you will see who will you see as kind of participants. Of course, the Christian lobby, the Jewish lobby, very strong, and the Muslim lobby. Because the Muslim lobby is very, very strong, so it has to be calmed down. So the media will give tremendous importance to Islam and Muslim lobby and completely ignore the Dharmic tradition. I've not seen a single program done by BBC which shows Hinduism, Sikhism, Buddhism or Jainism in a positive light. It always shows them as kind of weirdos. So it's a very frightening scenario. So the West has got a very poor opinion of that part of the world, and in the religion, the Dharmic tradition that came out of that particular world, part of the world, has been not given any exposure whatsoever. And the only exposure they give is to show some kind of weirdness in this tradition. Some, fakir smoking ganja, Hinduism. Come on now. So this is, if you like, the very poor way they portray Hinduism in the West. And I fight them all the time. Look, I tell you, again, I'm saying this on air. The BBC called me for some certain kind of, consultation regarding how religion should be presented in BBC. They had some very high power meeting with me, 2 or 3 hours wasted, spent, I should say. And I said, look, if you want to really promote how to present religion in this world that we live in, promote the two ideas at the heart of Hinduism, pluralism, many ways to be spiritual, and the idea of spiritual humanism, focusing on humanity and not on God in heaven. And the third thing I said you can plug in is to plug in the idea that science and spirituality are not that distant, they are kind of pointing in the same direction. Three things I can say, plug it in. And then I got a reply after 6 months of hassle. Mr. Lakhani, we have thought about it, we are going to talk about pluralism because we are going to, in a way, show a program on BBC about pilgrimage from here to Rome. This is pluralism? And what about this about science and spirituality? Well, spiritual humanism, completely ignored, because this goes against the Christian ethos. Dignifying humanity as the spark of God, that's not accepted, we are sinners. So again, spiritual humanism, zero. They told me we have no plans, no programs for that. Only program you're going to watch on BBC in the next year is going to be this pilgrimage to Rome. And the other program you'll watch is this idea of Diwali. Hindus love Diwali, they have fireworks. Just imagine how poorly Hinduism is portrayed in the mainstream media. To a great extent, they still have this colonial attitude, saying these are kind of secondary people, backward people, so we can show them in the way we like. We are still the masters. But one thing the Guardian newspaper said, which touched me, was this. Is they said, with the arrival of Narendra Modi on the political scene in India, first time the British rule has ended. He's not a clone of the British Empire. He's not going to play ball with them. So he's going to kind of promote the idea of Hinduism in an honest manner, in a sincere manner, refocus attention of that nation back to spirituality and not this kind of half-baked secularism that Nehru brought in.